Here we are at the Technofiber factory, and Technofiber is one of the most technologically advanced strings produced in the world, and it's produced right here in one of the oldest factories in France. Here we are inside the Technofiber string factory at Cuisine Frere, and I'm here with the factory's general manager, Jean-Christophe Francois, right? And he's going to tell us a little bit about the history of the factory. And this is a very old factory, correct?
Yes, it's a very, very old factory because it's more than two centuries that this building is existing. But we manufacture this kind of tennis string only for 25 years ago.
Okay.
So all the production of the Technofiber string, you can see, is here.
Okay, and there's not just tennis string manufactured here. There's also other products.
Yes. Could you tell us a little bit about that? Group, there is many products. So there is sewing thread, there is ropes, mountain ropes, climbing ropes, nautic ropes. Also, we have one part which is completely new, only 10 years ago, which is biomedical application, all the textile you can find in the body. And another part is around 20 years ago, is optical fiber application, telecommunication cable.
Great, and then just behind us, we have some of the raw materials. Let's go ahead and we'll go over and take a look at the raw material, which is the material they gather to make the tennis string. So when the string comes into the Technofiber string factory, it's on a large bobbin. The first thing they have to do is transfer it onto a smaller bobbin that can be used by the machine that makes the string. And even at this early stage, just transferring the string onto the small bobbin, the tension of which it's pulled on is very important, because that's going to affect production further down the line. So for different types of string, they're going to alter the tension used to transfer the string onto that smaller bobbin. We're standing in part of the production area of the factory now, and the raw material is being gathered, correct, onto the special size of the bobbin?
Of bobbin, yes.
And can you explain a little bit to us what's going on, what the machines are doing?
Yes. So on the bottom here, you can see that all the bobbin which has been prepared before are put on a special plate. This plate, depending on the string we will manufacture, will use different raw material and also different number of fiber. And as you can see, there is two bottles, and inside this bottle there is our glue, I would say, in order to fix all together the yarns.
Okay, and then you use the different bobbins with the different raw material depending on the type of string that's
exactly
being made.
Yes. In many kind of string you can find either only a multifilament, or you can have a mix with monofilament and multifilament. And on each bobbin, depending on the product you will manufacture, you will find multifilament or monofilament.
Okay, and then I understand these are very specific, you know, very unique machines to Technofiber. Can you tell us a little bit about the development of the machines?
Yes. In fact, all the machines that you can see here, you cannot buy it on the market. They have been designed here by the people from the R&D. Everything you can see, you cannot find it anywhere, because it's a special development from the factory.
And then when you obviously want to keep these machines top secret, right?
Yes.
So how do you ensure that it's kept secret when they're produced?
What we do, we are using many subcontractors, so they only have one part of the machine, each of them.
Okay.
So we are normally sure that you cannot find this kind of machine except here.
Got it. Okay, we've moved up above the machines, and we're just down below looking at the machines, the bobbins spinning around and the material being wound together to create the string. Now we're up above. Can you explain a little bit of what's happening up here?
Yes, so it's difficult to see, but the speed are very low. Maximum speed we can do is 45 meters per hour, so around 3 strings an hour. But anyway, we must do that because there is a very, very important point. It's that you must stay in the oven a certain amount of time with a very accurate temperature in order to fix all the fibers all together. And this is very important, because if you don't make that, the life duration of the string will be very low.
Okay.
And while of the specificity of the production here is that we have a very good lifetime for the string.
So you're producing about three sets of 40 feet, so
yes.
Three individual sets an hour?
An hour,
wow. Yeah. And so the temperature is very important. How about the tension?
The tension is also very important, and we will see that on the lab after that, because the tension we put on the yarn will give you the, how do you say that in English? I'm sorry, I'm not very good for that, but it's very important for the answer of the string when you will play.
The response.
The response, yes.
Okay. And then what else is happening to the string up here? So it's been to a specific tension, it's been heated.
It's heated at a specific tension. And just at the end, we have a last die, which also will permit to be sure of the diameter of the string.
Okay, so it goes from a very rough kind of string, and then when it comes out of that, it's...
It will be smooth.
Smooth and at a consistent gauge.
Exactly, yes.
Okay. So obviously the temperature is very important, and Technofiber have a specific room to control the temperature of the machines, and we're going to go down and look at that. But before we do, can you tell me how many machines you have working up here?
We have 84 machines here, which means that we produce during the year around 2 million strings.
Wow.
And due to the low speed, we have to work 7 days a week during the year.
Okay, let's cruise down and we'll have a look at the temperature control room. Can you explain what these machines are doing?
Yes, in fact here you are in the heart of the curing system of Technofiber product. As I told you before, the temperature is really important. If the temperature is too low, you can produce the string, but the quality will be really low. So here, every oven that you have seen on the machine are electronically controlled, mm-hmm. And if we had a trouble, we will have an alarm on each oven, which will stop the machine, and people will have to go to the machine to work on it.
Okay, and then once the machine's corrected, they'll just start again with, you know, start up the process. They don't have to change out the bobbins or anything. Everything else will be.
You can restart the machine if you stop around 1 minute, because the resin system is plastics. So if you don't stop too long time, you can restart.
Okay. So we've had a good look at how the string is produced. It's a very precise and methodic process. Now we're going to head over and check out some testing. So once they've got the string made, you know, how do they test it for performance, for durability, etc. So let's head over there.